honorable guest of the day, Dr. D.K. Agarwal, Chairman and Managing Director of SMC Investment and Advisors Limited, and President PGDCI, respected Vice Chairman, GLBIMR Group of Institutions, Mr. Pankaj Agarwal, Ravindra Pal Singh Ji, Ms. Jyoti, Sneha Sekhia Ji, Dean GLBIMR, present faculty members, and my dear students. On behalf of GLBIMR Institute of Management and Research, first of all, I take this opportunity to welcome these esteemed guests who are here recently to have deliberation on the startup related issues, ecosystem, and other avenues. Globally, startups are seen as national builders as they create positive contribution to the nation's economy and creation of jobs. Startups are normally identified as a newly emerged, fast-growing business that aims to meet a marketplace need by developing a viable business model around innovative products, services, process, or a platform. With their success, they also create a sense that indigenous innovations and technologies can bring fruitful economic benefits in the long run. The startup landscape is growing rapidly in our country. In order to sustain the growth and encourage startups, it is important for enablers to understand the life cycle of a startup. Every business or every activity passes through certain phases. So is with a startup also. Naturally, any startup starts with the conception of the idea. So that is called growth stage, initial stage, which we may say stage one. An entrepreneur treats multiple stages of business life cycle of a startup from birth, that is an idea, through its maturity. Each new phase brings forth new challenges that the entrepreneur must learn to navigate. Important point is that in each phase, in each stage, you are required to remain very cautious, very alert, because you need to navigate the challenges very successfully. Concept or idea stage, all of you have gone through product life cycle and you know what are the different stages. The entrepreneur discovers a problem or identifies an opportunity that has a business potential. Mentorship support for entrepreneurs is critical at this stage to ensure the business related activities are defined well and subsequent business plan is generated. At this stage, there is not much requirement of funding and typically founders tend to self-finance or bootstrap. Pre-seed or validation stage. Entrepreneur builds a problem solution in the form of a proof of concept or prototype, you can say, with relevant assumptions. These assumptions are then validated with initial small sample of target audience for the product or service related feedback and response. The funding requirements are generally met by self-financing, both strapping, raising money from investors, or government grants for research or prototype development. Access to incubator and mentors at this stage helps in identifying and approaching early customers, building minimum viable product and identifying product market fit. These basic knowledge grooming is essential for all these students and for all those who may thinking of starting a new business enterprise in future. It is not necessary that all these students or all the business planners may think at this stage, say for these students at this early stage, but later in your life, you may think of planning something to start on your own, which we call a startup. But for any startup, you must have inquisitiveness to look upon the opportunities, to look upon the market, to look upon the demand, and to create a basic idea initially, which can be further nurtured to create a product. Based on the feedback from early customers and mentors' insights, demand for product or service is identified. The customer retention rate confirms the early traction of the company and its products. A startup acquires more customers by actively seeking funds from crowdfunding agencies, angel investors or networks, incubators, and seed grants from government. The financing support at this stage supports the startup in escaping the valley of death for a period of time spanning from when a startup firm receives an initial capital contribution to when it begins generating revenues. Initially, in any business, you know that generating revenue, that remains a challenge. Initial investment is required, and one person who has started a business or one who is involved in a business is required to bear the steps which may pull you towards that track. You will have to be very cautious, you will have to generate patience, you will have to have proper idea or proper designing of the, you can say, incubation period, the period for which you will have to sustain only in order to see that certain turnover of your business is starting. Then comes growth or scaling stage. In this stage, most of the processes are defined and the business is firmly established. Entrepreneurs build a repeatable user or customer acquisition process, identify channels of market growth, and look for opportunities to expand the business to difficult geographies or markets. The expansion is backed by a scale of funding support from institutional investors such as venture capitalists and acceleration programs. And finally, as you have studied also, maturity or IPO or M&A stage come. Many investors, promoters and founders look at opportunity to exit also and realize profit either through partial or full sale of their business entity. The next set of investors may be identified as another entity in the same space looking to acquire the business and gain market share. Or in some cases, a startup may issue a public offer or entirely sell the business. Bank funds, private equity funds or IPO investors play a major role in financing such large deals of startups. So, basic concept behind startup is, it's a new business naturally. It's a business generally not initiated with large amount of fund or backup. It is being taken or considered as an idea initially, which may bring fruitful results and employment too. And it passes through different stages which you have already studied, but remains a cautious step, requires a cautious step at every stage. And finally, if anyone plans to have a startup, naturally it will be successful if you have patience and if you have enough strength to sustain the business plan and execution. While several research papers and journals that provide advice for entrepreneurship have come into light, a few common ingredients that help foster successful ecosystems can be categorized into 9 different stages, of which first is government policy and regulatory framework. In India, central and state government are playing an active role in startup ecosystem development. The key objective of the government are spur entrepreneurial activity to accelerate job creation, create enabling environment by reducing regulatory burden and introducing new policies, build capacity through infrastructure creation and training, provide funding support and fiscal incentives, facilitate all members of the startup ecosystem to collaborate and connect. Second is infrastructure support and incubators that you have already been told by your teachers in the classes. It enables such as incubator are also important partners in the overall startup ecosystem which supports and accelerates successful development of businesses. Then comes funding and finance. I already told you, initially you may get angel investor, then earlier stage investor, then later stage investor depending upon your life cycle. Then culture of a place, of a country. India is a young nation with average age of 29 years. Our youth need to be encouraged to venture out and build successful enterprises. The word fail need to be redefined as first attempt in learning to inculcate the culture of risk and failure. Consistent effort by the government are bringing cultural transformation in India, and now there is defining growth in number of startups from Tier 1 and Tier 2 cities in the country. Then mentors, advisors and support system. Then most important, the place where you are. Universities as catalysts. Major universities are promoting, and major institutions are also promoting, a culture of respect for entrepreneurship by including the courses in that curriculum, in their curriculum, setting up technology and business incubators, setting up entrepreneurship skill set, providing sustenance allowance to student entrepreneurs, introducing break year concepts and deferred placements. Then comes human capital and workforce, then local and global markets, and finally, which I told you several times, it's your sustenance and it's your zeal which will make any startup successful. In India, in August 2015, Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi announced the launch of National Flagship Initiative, Startup India, with a mandate to promote and encourage young entrepreneurs of our country. He envisioned the aim of the initiative to transform India into a startup nation, a country of job creators instead of job seekers. Since then, a lot of efforts have been made. All the states in the country have a startup. While Maharashtra is leading in this league, all the places, all the states, even the smaller states, are venturing a startup. And it is being believed that in another 10 years, India will be among the top startup nations of the globe. With these words, I close my session. I wish all these students that in future, while they might be going for initially job to sustain or to meet the expectation of their family, many of you must look upon the government support system and must generate certain ideas to have a startup so that you may be job provider, you may be among the nation builders, or you may be among those who can be among the top 10 in the top 10 countries globally. Thank you very much.